Hi viewer, I welcome you to Elim TV. It is the station where you watch and learn. I'll be taking you through Geography Form 2, Lesson Number 12. The topic it is internal land forming processes. Welcome. Our lesson goes today we are going to do. By the end of the lesson, the learner should be able to look at the features associated with fountain, should be able to know them. We start by looking at these features. Different effects of fountain result into the formation of physical features. So when the fountain takes place, when the compression force, anticlinal aching, we also have the tension, the shear and tear force are subjected to the cluster rocks. It results to the physical features like the fault scarp, the block mountain, tilt block, rift valley, and others. So we are going to look at each at a time. We start by looking at the fault scarp. So when we talk about the fault scarp, it is that steep slope formed by the vertical movement of the earth along a fault. It is the steep slope. It is the face of a fault plane facing the down throw. So it is that face that is facing down throw. It is also referred to as an escarpment. How is it formed? It is formed when two parallel faults occur on a landmass forming a central block as shown in the diagram that is below. We are going to look at it. The two land masses on either side of the central block are pulled away from the central block by the tension force. So that is when now we have that steep slope facing the down throw being formed. And an example of this one, we have the Mau, Nyandarua, Nyando, Helgon Marakwet escarpment. All these are found in Kenya. That is in Grigory Rift Valley. Then we also have others that are found in Tanzania, which is also in the Great Rift Valley. That is the Manyara escarpment. We also have the Chunya escarpment. All these are found in Tanzania. Then in Uganda, in the Western Rift Valley, we have the Butiaba scarp. Let us see the way it looks like. If you look at the where we have the fault scarp, you can be able to see the up throw. You can also see the down throw. The fault scarp, we have already said it faces the down throw, as you can be able to see. Then we have the line of weaknesses. That result to that that block, one of them going downwards, then the others going upward. We go to the second one, which is the block mountain. A block mountain is an elongated upland bounded by the fault scarps on both sides. So this one now, it is a mountain that is bounded by the fault scarps or the escarpments. It is formed in two ways. It can be formed when the block land between two faults is uplifted. So uplifting of the central block. Or, and this one it is done or it takes place when compression force is applied in the faulting process. Or, it can also take place or it can be formed on either side of the central block that sinks as a result of tension force. And an example of these fault blocks, the block mountains, we have the Ruwenzori and Usambara Mountain. The third one, it is the tilt block. If the middle block has greater uplift on one side, then the fault block is not flat at the top, but tilted. It is then becomes a tilt block. Then the fourth feature, it is the rift valley. Rift valley is a narrow trough between more or less faults with steep faults on either side. So this is a narrow trough. It is not all that small. It is a very narrow one. And it must have the faults lines parallel past one another. Then, when we talk about the fault scarps or the escarpments, they are steep. And we have the major Rift Valley that we have. We have the Great Rift Valley. We also have the Rhine Rift Valley. We also have the Baikal Rift Valley. Those are the Rift Valley that we have in the whole world. When I talk about the Great Rift Valley, this is found in Africa. The Rhine Valley, it is found in Eurasia. The Baikal Rift Valley, it is also found there. The foreign theories have been put forward to explain the formation of the Rift Valley. One of them, it is the tension theory. For the tension theory, it is that force, or it is that Rift Valley that is formed when we have the tension force being applied. Where the compression theory, it is the one that is where now we have the compression force being applied. Then we have the anticlinal aching theory. We are going to look at these theories in our next lesson. So the activity for today, state the features associated with faulting. For more information, you can visit the KRB 2003 Secondary Geography Student Book 2, that edition. If at all you want to get us, you can get us either your SMS to us, you also get us from the YouTube, you can also get us from through the Facebook, you can also Twitter us. Stay tuned to EdimTV. Thank you.